Hey guys, in this video we'll see some of the tips to be used inside your Kotlin code. We will be looking into these three tips. First one is ktlint, then detect, and finally GitHub workflows. Ktlint, which is an anti-bike shedding Kotlin linter, is given us by Pinterest. There are two ways of using ktlint in a Kotlin project. We'll use this one. Let's first go to our project structure. Next, we create a directory called build scripts. Inside the build scripts, we create a file called ktlint.cradle. And if we click on it, we see the version which we are importing and some of the configurations. The aim of this ktlint.cradle file is all the configuration of ktlint resides in this file. Heading over to the Android structure, we now need to add the configuration of ktlint inside our project build.cradle. Here, we add in the dependency of the ktlint cradle and we specify the plugin version as 10.2.0. Under the repositories, we add a new one called as Maven with the specified URL. And since we had a separate Gradle file for ktlint Gradle, we add it under the subprojects, which says to apply it from the folder build scripts and the file name being ktlint.cradle. By adding the Gradle inside the subprojects, we basically tell that all the modules inside this project should be following this ktlint configuration. Now let's click on the sync now, which will basically configure and install the ktlint inside our project. After the Gradle sync is done successfully, we now see a new task inside a Gradle called as ktlint format. And if we double click to run this, it will scan through all our project files, Kotlin files, and check for the errors. So in this case, it has shown us some errors. Now let's see. Now let's click this text file which is generated by ktlint and it shows us the error in which file, which in this case is navgraph.kt, and what is it expecting from us to solve this problem. After solving all the errors reported by ktlint, let's run this task again, and this time it should be successful, and yes it is. See a sample of how does ktlint helps us in formatting. So we open any Kotlin file, let's say a backup button in our case. So now let's add in some extra spaces. And once we run this task, ktlint format, it should correct or remove the spaces, which it does. So all these type of indentations and extra spaces and all the other stuff is automatically taken care by this ktlint across all the Kotlin files. Next, we see a static code analyzer tool called as detect for Kotlin. One of the prime features of detect is to detect the code smell for our Kotlin projects, and it's highly customizable, highly configurable, and also generates a report based on our project. So let's see how to set up this. Inside our app, we again switch to the project structure and create a Gradle file for detect. This detect Gradle file comprises of the reports, how the format we want, and it comprises of a config file, which doesn't exist for now, but we'll see how we can generate it. Switching back to the Android structure and going inside the project build.cradle, we add the dependency for detect and specify the detect version as 1.17.0. Since our detect has its own Gradle file, so we again inform our project to apply it from that detect.gradle file present in build scripts, and it's under the subprojects. So all the modules or all the subprojects will comply or will by default follow the detect or Gradle guidelines. Finally, we click on the sync now Gradle. And after the Gradle is successfully synced, we should see some additional tasks related to detect. Let's open our Gradle, and inside our tasks, under the verification, we would see now a bunch of Gradle tasks related to detect. One of the tasks here is to generate the detect config, which, if you recall, in the earlier setup of detect, we specified it would take a config file. So after running this task, we should see a config file. So it creates a config folder, and inside it, a detect subfolder, and there is our YAML file, detect.yaml file. This YAML file is like a huge configurable file which you can customize according to your project requirement. But as of now, we just kept it as it is, so it's taking the default configuration. Now let's run detect inside our project. So this is done by the command detect. So it scans across our project using the configuration file, and it's failed. So let's see why. So detect detects four issues, and let's see what are those issues. So it says some magic number at these files and gives an estimate about the technical debt in minutes. So let's see these files now. As per the configuration, detect thinks this hex is basically a magic number, but for this file, since it's a color, we need this number basically. So for this case, we can suppress this warning. This is done by specifying an annotation file, and inside it, we say the configuration name as magic number. So this basically implies that for this file, let's ignore magic number warning. Let's run the detect again. So this time, the build should be successful. We now add a GitHub workflow for our Kotlin project. So for this, we create a directory.github, and inside it, we create a subfolder called as workflows. Next, we create a YAML file called android_build. In this file, we have some steps. So first is the checkout, then we set up the JDK, build our project, run the tests, and finally do the checks. And if we recall, this last step, which includes GradleW, ktlincheck, and detect, these are nothing but Gradle tasks. Both of these tasks can be found here, and the other one, it's here. So whenever we push any branch to our repository, so this will trigger all these checks. Here, this is my repository, and if we head over to the actions, we can see here the workflow Android build, which takes in from Android build YAML. And looking deep into this, we see the build action, and these are the steps which it took. So here we see lint checks, which was one of our steps. And if we open this, we see our ktlincheck and detect. Lastly, inside my branch in the settings, we have require status checks to pass, and the status check to pass is build, which is nothing but the Android build workflow which we saw previously. That's it from this video, guys. Source code and article links are mentioned in the description below, and thanks guys for watching.